Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. And as always, be sure to check out the video description for links to upcoming events, t-shirts, books, ways to support this channel. And in particular, I want to call your attention to the fact that I am planning to give conference workshops on C++ best practices in September in Kongsberg, Sweden at NDC Tech Town, in October in Aurora, Colorado at CPP Con. In this episode, I'm going to talk about the static initialization order fiasco and constinit's role in this world. So be sure you stick around for this and see if you can learn something new. So using compiler explorers, I think relatively rarely used project mode here, where we can have an actual CMake project in compiler explorer, I'm going to demonstrate what this is all about. I have set up a simple provider consumer framework, and I know the font's going to be a little small because there's a lot going on. But in my provider, I have declared a thing called provider. It has a default constructor of some sort that is explicitly out of line for the sake of this conversation today. And it can provide integers. Let's make these things public. And then I have a consumer. And the consumer similarly has an explicitly out of line default constructor and a function that can consume a single int. So at the moment, I just have simple empty implementations for the default constructor for consumer and for provider. And I have my main.cpp, and that's just to give an entry point to this program. We're really not going to be worrying about main so much right now. Now, let's come up with a hypothetical. Let's say that we are going to define a world where there is a global provider and a global consumer. And I really must state right now that this is a terrible idea, and you really shouldn't be writing programs with global mutable state, but hopefully you'll believe me by the end of this episode. So let's just say in my consumer's constructor, I want to consume an element from the global provider. Now, right now I don't have a global provider, so let's go ahead and define one. I have told the compiler at some point, expect there to be a global provider created. And then in provider CPP, I'm going to go ahead and define this thing. Now in the consumer's CPP file, I need to include this provider. And I'm getting a compilation now with an undefined reference to the provide function. And I just realized we should probably spice things up a little bit. And instead of an int, let's provide strings. Okay, let's go ahead in main and create a consumer. Now, when it is default constructed, it's going to access that global provider, it's going to get a string, and it's going to attempt to print it in its consume function. Okay, so this code works as expected. Our consumer's default constructor is in fact accessing the global provider, and it is printing out this hello there world string. And we have not actually caused the static initialization order fiasco yet. To do that, what we need is two different statics that both rely on each other. So I'm going to declare that there is a global consumer as well. And then in my main, I am going to create no object at all. And I'm still getting hello there world printed, but there's no guarantee that that's actually going to work. And the problem comes down to which global static was created first. If the consumer had its lifetime begin first, then it's going to access a provider that did not yet have its lifetime begin. And if the provider has its lifetime begin first, then the consumer works exactly like it's supposed to. And we can attempt to exploit this with a few different things here. Now, I am actually compiling the provider first. I'm just going to attempt to move consumer first in my CMake list file and see if that is enough to exploit this problem. Yes, in fact, we can actually see that the program is not outputting anything more at all because I put consumer before provider. I'm just going to go ahead and put consumer after provider again, and we can verify that we are getting our hello world string printed. So that is the static initialization order fiasco in a nutshell. Now, where constinit comes into play is if we wanted to say that this provider is going to be constant initialized. Like, we want to guarantee that this is initialized before the program starts. Well, it has to have a constexpr constructor, and it simply can't have a constexpr constructor in this case because a constexpr string cannot live outside of constexpr context. But I will use this to illustrate to you what constinit does. Let's go ahead and get rid of that declaration. And we're going to just use this one. And I'm now going to say this is constinit. And this is going to require that provider have a constexpr constructor. Now, C++ 20 is when we got constinit. And we're going to get this error: constinit variable global provider does not have a constant initializer. So we have to do something to give it a constant initializer if we really want to do this. And that would mean giving this a constexpr constructor. Let's go ahead and get rid of that implementation of the constructor. And now we have a single constexpr constructor. And this says call to non-constexpr function, which is string's default constructor. Now, actually, string does have a constexpr constructor in C++ 20, but we have to have a new enough compiler to get us there. So we're going to upgrade to trunc, and we're probably still going to get a compile time error. Yes, now we have multiple definition of our global provider. Now this finally compiles, but there are a couple of important notes to make. First is that we don't really have any way of initializing this string here. We can change things around. Like, if we want to say that it's always going to provide the same exact string, then we could do something like this. And if we are consuming string-like things with our consumer, then it's fair that we probably want to actually consume string views instead. And we are getting that hello there world printed again. Now, I want to make a couple of points here. Let's go back into our provider. First of all, this thing had to be constexpr constructible for us to use constinit. Second of all, constinit does not mean const. So it's an object that is initialized at compile time. That is the key here. Now, marking this constinit did not actually change the behavior of the program at all. let's make sure that we have a broken CMake here. Let's put the consumer.cpp before provider, which we knew would mess things up previously, and verify that we do in fact still get our string printed. And we do. What constinit does is it validates your assumptions. This simply validates my assumptions. I can go in and I can remove these constinits from the two places that I have forward declared and then defined my global provider. And I'm still going to get the same output from my program. There is no problem with lifetime here. So that is the main point of constinit, and it is that it verifies our assumptions about what is being initialized at compile time or not. So for the sake of the end of this video, I'm going to go ahead and put back in the constinit here, so all of the comments make sense. I will save a link to this, and hopefully that cleared up a few things. We covered the static initialization order fiasco, and that is the problem where you have two statics that rely on each other in some way, and you have no way to guarantee which one is going to actually begin its lifetime first. That is an implementation-defined detail. The second thing we covered is that anything that is a static, that is constexpr constructible, is going to naturally be initialized at compile time. It is going to be, quote, constant initialized. And the third thing that we have covered is that if you use constinit, you are validating your assumptions about the initialization of an object. You are not actually changing the meaning of your code. So thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to subscribe.